Do you need to learn more about how to solve trigonometric equations or just need a quick review? After years of teaching math, I've come up with an easily understandable way to teach students how to solve these equations. Welcome to Understand the Math. We've created free guided notes that you can use as you watch this video and placed a link to them in the video description below. There's space in the notes for you to highlight the important concepts and to fill out the answers to the examples that we're going to do. In this video, we're going to solve three trig equations that are similar to most of the equations you'll encounter. If you want to see additional examples, I have a playlist called Solving Trigonometric Equations that you can check out. The first equation that we'll solve is sine 2 theta plus cosine theta is equal to 0. This equation has both a 2 theta and a theta in it. We need to change this equation so it just has theta in it, and to do this, we'll need to use a trig identity. I've placed a link in the video description below to a comprehensive list of these identities that you can download and use as a reference. We'll use the identity sine of 2 theta is equal to 2 sine theta cosine theta. We'll then plug this into our equation. This gives 2 sine theta cosine theta plus cosine theta is equal to 0. We can pull out a cosine theta, and this gives 2 sine theta plus 1 is equal to 0. We can break this down into two equations. Cosine theta is equal to 0, and 2 sine theta plus 1 is equal to 0. The second equation becomes sine theta is equal to minus 1/2. Let's first look at the equation cosine theta is equal to 0. On the unit circle, cosine theta is equal to x, and x is equal to 0 at these two points. At these two points, theta is equal to the arc cosine of 0. At the point on the top, theta is equal to pi over 2, and at the point on the bottom, theta is equal to 3 pi over 2. To account for all the angles, we'll write that theta is equal to pi over 2 plus 2n pi, and theta is equal to 3 pi over 2 plus 2n pi. Let's now look at the equation sine theta is equal to minus 1/2. On the unit circle, sine theta is equal to y, and y is equal to minus 1/2 at these two points. It's easiest to find theta if we look at the reference angle, which is in the first quadrant, and located at this point. At this point, sine theta sub r is equal to 1/2, and theta sub r is the arc sine of 1/2, which is equal to pi over 6. To find theta in the third and fourth quadrants, we can use the reference angle chart that I've included here at the bottom of the page. In quadrant 3, theta is equal to pi plus theta sub r. This gives theta is equal to pi plus pi over 6, which is equal to 7 pi over 6. To account for all the angles, we'll write theta is equal to 7 pi over 6 plus 2n pi. In the fourth quadrant, theta is equal to 2 pi minus theta sub r. This is equal to 2 pi minus pi over 6, which is equal to 11 pi over 6. We'll write this as theta is equal to 11 pi over 6
plus 2n pi.
Our equation has an infinite number of solutions, which we'll go ahead and highlight. The second equation we'll solve is 1 plus cosine theta is equal to 2 sine squared theta. Let's begin by writing this equation as 2 sine squared theta minus cosine theta minus 1 is equal to 0. Since we can't factor out a sine theta or a cosine theta like we did in the first equation that we solved, we need to change this equation so it just has a cosine theta or a sine theta in it. To do this, we need to write either sine theta or cosine theta in terms of the other one. We can do this by using the Pythagorean theorem, sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is equal to 1. Since we have a cosine theta in our equation, let's solve for sine squared theta, and then our equation will just contain cosines.
We can write this as sine squared theta is equal to 1 minus cosine squared theta. Let's plug this into our equation. This gives 2 times the quantity 1 minus cosine squared theta minus cosine theta minus 1 is equal to 0. Multiplying things through, we get minus 2 cosine squared theta minus cosine theta plus 1 is equal to 0. Let's multiply this through by a negative, and we get 2 cosine squared theta plus cosine theta minus 1 is equal to 0. We can factor this equation. We have a 2 cosine theta, and then we'll have a cosine theta. These terms will be 1, and then we need a positive cosine theta in the middle, so this needs to be a plus 1, and that needs to be a minus 1. This gives us 2 cosine theta minus 1 is equal to 0, and this equation is cosine theta plus 1 is equal to 0. From the equation on the left, we get cosine theta is equal to 1/2, and the equation on the right gives us cosine theta is equal to minus 1. Let's first look at the equation cosine theta is equal to 1/2. Cosine theta is equal to x, and x is equal to 1/2 at these two points. In our first quadrant, our theta will be equal to arc cosine of 1/2, and this is equal to pi over 3. We see from our reference angle chart that our angle in the fourth quadrant is going to be equal to 2 pi minus theta sub r. This gives us theta is equal to 2 pi minus pi over 3, which is equal to 5 pi over 3. We can then write our solutions as theta is equal to pi over 3 plus 2n pi, and theta is equal to 5 pi over 3 plus 2n pi. Let's now look at cosine theta is equal to minus 1. Cosine theta is equal to x, and x is equal to minus 1 at this point. This gives us an angle of theta is equal to pi, and then we'll tack on 2n pi to account for all the other angles. Let's now highlight the solutions to this equation.
If you're finding this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. The last equation that we'll solve is 2 sine 3 theta minus root 2 is equal to 0. This is an example of an equation where we have a trig function with an angle other than theta. In this equation, we have an angle of 3 theta. We'll first write down our equation. We have 2 sine 3 theta minus root 2 is equal to 0. Let's now solve this for sine 3 theta. This gives sine 3 theta is equal to root 2
over 2.
Our approach for solving this equation will be to first solve for 3 theta and then solve for theta. In this example, we only have one equation to solve. As we saw in our first example, sine theta is equal to y, and y is root 2 over 2, which is approximately 0.7
at these two points. In the first quadrant, our angle 3 theta is equal to the arc sine of root 2 over 2. This is equal to pi over 4.
We're going to include the 2 in pi at this point because when we divide by 3, this value is going to change.
Solving for theta gives us theta is equal to pi over 12 plus 2n pi over 3. We'll go ahead and highlight this solution.
Before we find our solution in the second quadrant, let's make a note that 3 times our reference angle theta sub r is equal to pi over 4. We don't need to include the 2n pi with it.
In our second quadrant, our angle is equal to pi minus theta sub r. In a similar way, 3 theta is equal to pi minus 3 theta sub r.
We found that 3 theta sub r is equal to pi over 4, and we'll plug that in.
We have 3 theta is equal to pi minus pi over 4. This gives us 3 theta is equal to 3 pi over 4. Let's now account for all the angles and add in our 2n pi. So we get 3 theta is equal to 3 pi over 4 plus 2n pi. We then divide by 3 and we get theta is equal to pi over 4 plus 2n pi over 3.
We'll now highlight the second solution. I hope that you now have a better understanding of how to solve trigonometric equations and feel ready to solve some equations on your own. If you need to see some more examples, just click on the playlist that's listed on the end screen coming up. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.